What's going on, guys? PixCamp20 back in with a brand new video, and it has come to my attention that we are at a track that I do not like. It is Brands Hatch, as we are doing our Manufacturer Cup race in the Honda NSX, and we are not the only Honda NSX in this lobby, as we do have two or three other guys driving the Honda NSX, so it's going to be a really big feat for us to try to finish in a good spot, as it's going to be important to get the most amount of points in this lobby, because if those Honda NSXs finish ahead of us, then we can lose a lot of positions in our standings for our fight to the top on the manufacturer standing. So ranked 11th in this lobby, as we are in the second split lobby. We're gonna see what we can do here, as again, we are at Brands Hatch, a track that I just do not like for the love of me. I mean, I'm really good at this track. I can put in some really competitive lap times, but I just don't like this track when it comes down to it. But going to the points table, we are fighting for 246 points if we get first place. So we're going to see what we can do here, as a lot of the handling cars were doing really, really well around this track. So a lot of front wheel driving cars, WRXs, Mitsubishi Lancers, and the Porsches were doing the best in this track. So before we jump into qualifying, if you guys really enjoy the content, please subscribe to the channel and leave a like on the video. It really helps out the channel when you guys do so. Anyways, that's enough promoting myself. Let's jump straight into qualifying. Coming out of our qualifying lap, this is our first flyer lap, and I was actually really, really confident in this lap, as I felt like we hit all our marks. Crossing the start-finish line, we get a 128.346, which is actually the fastest lap that I ever posted around here in the Group 4 car. And that was good enough to get us into third place, as we now see the qualifying is completed, and we're going to start in third place right behind the Toyota and the McLaren. So it brings a lot of confidence to our race, as we are now coming to the intro. The strategy for this race was we are given the softs, the mediums, and the hards. So all three compounds are used up in this race, but we had to use the mediums and the hards. So we're going to jump on the softs, use them from the beginning of the race all the way to lap number 11, and then switch off from the mediums to lap 12 to 17. And on the final lap, we're going to switch off to the hards and see if we can hold off our position, if we are fighting for a position here. But fuel consumption was kind of non-existent. All you had to do was just save a little bit of fuel in the beginning, and you should be fine till the end of the race. But we're going to see what we can do here as we now jump into the race. As we jump into the race now, we get a 3-2-1, and we are a go, as we are following the McLaren and the Toyota into turn number 1. Crossing the start-finish line, the Toyota is starting to shift left and right as he's trying to get heat into the tires, as we safely maneuver our way into turn number 1. Coming out of turn number 1, we're heading uphill into turn number 2 as we are following the McLaren and the Toyota. And kind of my game plan here was to follow these two cars, stay right behind them in the slipstream, and hopefully they can pull us away from the rest of the pack, as these two guys were very, very quick. But I'm not sure exactly how the Honda NSX is going to handle all these corners, especially because some cars behind us were using faster cars. But you can see in fifth place, there's a Porsche lurking in the woods here, as he's actually already able to get past one of the Porsches. And he's now trying to force his way onto the inside past another Porsche. He's got just so much straight line speed compared to these other cars. And you can see now we are on his radar as we come out of this left-hander heading into the final part of lap number 1. So jumping into lap number 2 here, we're coming out of the final corner. As you can see now, the Peugeot is right behind us as he's getting closer and closer to us. And we're just keeping an eye on him, as the top two were able to break away from us. And unfortunately, we were unable to stay with him in the slipstream. But you can see again, the Peugeot is just getting closer and closer to us. So I'm just keeping my eyes on him, keeping an eye on the radar, and also trying to hit all our marks, as we're going to do everything we can to stay ahead of this Peugeot, as we do have him on the corners just a tad bit, but he has us on the straight line speed. So when we get onto the straightaways, we're going to do everything we can to hold our position and defend ourselves as we now come in at the left-hander. So as we now come into lap number 3, you can see right behind us now that the Peugeot is creeping ever so closely to us. As we're now heading to the final corner, we're staying onto the inside, as you can see he's now on our radar, and that's starting to worry me. As I'm gonna keep it onto the outside and shift onto the inside, defend our position as we head into turn number 1. Coming to turn number 1, he's in our slipstream. He's getting closer and closer and just hunting us down like a shark, and he's able to pounce on us and get around us. But we're gonna try to do an undercut here as we try to go into the inside, make an easy cut back here as we're going into turn number 2, staying onto the inside. He gives us race space on the inside, we give him space on the outside, and we're going side by side now as we're heading to turn number 3. But he's got the inside going to turn number 3. He cuts right in front of us, and we let him go as we do not want to fight with him anymore and allow fifth place to get even closer to us. So we're just going to follow the Peugeot here and see if he can pull us up to the top two cars as we head into this left-hander. So As we come into the left-hander, you can just see how much time that he gains on us coming out of those corners. You can see on the straightaway, he just pulls away from us as the Persians just has too much front end speed compared to us. And it just sucks right now because we are doing everything that we can to stay with him, but we just cannot do it with this Honda NSX. We do not have enough grip, and we do not have the power to stay with the Peugeot as we are now jumping up into lap number 11. Nothing really happened throughout the race as we were just staying right behind the Peugeot, just trying to keep up with him. But you can see a couple cars behind us are coming to the pits. So we're going to have to come into the pits now as we are jumping into lap number 12. Getting closer and closer to the Peugeot as the Peugeot is starting to lose grip in the front tires. We're going to have to come into the pits or follow whatever the Peugeot does. Because if he stays out, then we are going to stay out because we're just gaining so much time on him. But if he comes in, we have to come in because we cannot allow him to gain any more time on us. As he comes into the pits, we decide to jump into the pits as well. And we're going to switch off from the softs to the mediums as we're going to use that, not put any fuel. See what happens here as we come out of the pit stop now. So coming out of the pits, you can see that the Peugeot actually comes out on the hards. And this is very, very interesting as he's going to be on the hards. We're going to be in the medium. So this gives us a great opportunity to try to get around him. But you can see that we have to make up at least a 5/10 of a second gap deficit on him. And hopefully that third place car can hold him up just a little bit. Just enough so that we can get around him. Hold him up just a tad bit. And then try to see if we can get the undercut on him when we have to come in for our hards. So coming out of the left-hander, we're staying on the slipstream of the Peugeot. And he's just pulling us along faster and faster to him as we go a little bit wide coming into the beginning of that left-hander. We actually make a little mistake there and it costs us a little bit of time, and you can see again how much the Peugeot's top end speed is now starting to pull him away from us, and this is not good for us as that is going to lead into about a 7/10, 8/10 deficit from us to him as again he is on the hards and we are on the mediums, but we are not able to make up that much time on him as we are going to have to stay on these mediums all the way up until lap number 17, and he's going to switch off from the hards to the mediums and run those all the way to the end of the race. So coming out of the end of lap number 13, he comes into the pits and he's going to switch off from his hards to the mediums as we now have to catch up to the third place driver and see if we can get around him. I think he only did one pit stop so far, or he hasn't came in, as I think he's just trying to stretch out the softs as much as he can as we come into the final corner. Coming out of the final corner on lap number 16, third place comes into the pits early. So yeah, I'm assuming that he started on the softs, just stayed on the softs as long as he could, and he's going to switch off from the softs to probably the mediums or the hards. As you can see right there, he actually switched off to the mediums. And right here, this is our money lap as we are now on lap number 17. We have to switch off from the mediums to the hards. But did we build a big enough gap to the Peugeot in order to hold him up and stay on third place position when we come in and switch off to the hards? We're going to see right here as we're coming now into the final corner. And you can see the top two guys are switching off from the mediums to the hards. So we're on a good winning strategy, but not sure if we were able to gain enough time away from the Peugeot to hold off our podium. Coming to the pits here, we're switching off to the hards, and you can see the Peugeot is now on the front stretch, past the start finish line here as we are now coming out of the pits. Where are we going to come out in? We come out in fourth place as the Peugeot just gets a 2-second gap away from us, and that is podium game over for us as we are now coming into the end of the final lap. Coming to the final corner, we are unable to make the gap up, and we're going to finish this race in fourth place after starting in third place, as that Peugeot just had way too much top end speed and had way too much grip compared to us, and he was able to outperform us when we came down to game time. So finishing in fourth, very disappointing. I wish we could have finished on the podium, but at least we were able to be the highest finishing NSX in this lobby, so something to be happy about. And at least we ran away with some points, as we were able to get 215 points. Just very, very unfortunate that we were unable to get a podium, as again, this is my least favorite track on the game, but we did really, really well as our qualifying time was a really good qualifying time, and our race pace wasn't too shabby, but again, just couldn't outperform that Peugeot and the McLaren and the Toyota. So if you guys found this video very entertaining, well, please subscribe to the channel and leave a like on the video, as it really helps the channel when you guys do so. And if you guys really enjoyed this video, I hope to see you guys on the next one. Peace out.